Probably a lot of you will already know that I really like Sanke, Kwaku and Showa. And hence I want to do another video on Sanke selection. But this time, not that I am explaining all the details, but what I will do, I will select these Sanke that are in the bowl. And after watching this video, you will exactly know which factors you should look for when you want to select or buy a really nice Sanke for your own pond, maybe even. So there are a lot of factors that influence the potential of a Sanke. Think about, for example, the skin quality, the body structure, the patterns, of course, are really important in young koi like these, so tosai in the first year. And now I have to say I have already discussed the Sanke before. And I will also link to that video in the description. Because I think if you really like Sanke and you want to know more about them, you should really watch that video as well. Maybe even before you watch this video, where I select these Sanke. What I will do, I will go through them one by one and tell you why I select certain Sankes and why I would not select certain Sankes. So yeah, let's just start and see where we end up. So what you will learn in this video is more about the sumi placement. And sumi are the black areas on the koi and also the black that still needs to develop. You will learn a little bit about the he patterns, so the red patterns on the fish. I will tell a little bit about body formation and body structure. Like main aspects you have to look for, like the three-colored shoulder on a Sanke with the katazumi. I will tell something about tejime, so the fins and the black in the fins. The shiroshi, so the whiteness of the fish. The intensity of the colors overall. The eyes. Well, probably even more than that. Just watch the video, enjoy, and learn something. Time to get started. We have 2021 Sanke in this bowl, all from breeder Izumiya. We will select them one by one, as I explained. I will give a little bit more description on each Sanke while I select them. And yeah, just enjoy. And of course, if you want to know something about certain aspects of a Sanke, leave it in the comments. I will try to help you out on that. But for now, yeah, let's zoom in a little bit more so you can see a little bit more details on what I'm doing and why I select certain ones or do not select others. Now, I just randomly picked 20 Sanke. So it's not that I picked the best already and I'm going to further select them. It's just all random. So I don't even know what I have in my bowl. I'm looking at it now. And I find it quite interesting, to be honest, because there's really a lot of different koi in here. And I will just start with, I think, quite a nice koi for a lot of you. It's this Sanke. What you can see on this Sanke is that it has a really a lot small sumi placements. Well, that is quite nice. It looks playful. But honestly, for a good Sanke, all of this is a little bit too messy. But what is good is that the intensity of the sumi is good. But you can see underneath the skin, there's still a little bit more black visible. And it's showing is the gray, shady areas that will all become black later. Well, most potentially that will become black. And I think that this Sanke will become too dark. Too much sumi on it, and for that reason I cannot select it. Even though I really like it, it's playful at this size, nice red dots, red markings, missing some red markings on this side, but overall nice fish, but I can't select it for now. So I would suggest to look for a Sanke that is a little bit more balanced. Then the next one, it's this one. This one is also a little bit darker and I will not select it for the same reason as I just mentioned for the previous one. I have to say, this Sanke, well, most of these Sanke have nice blue eyes. And the eyes is, yeah, the blue eyes is really something nice on a koi with red on the skin, so also for Sanke. That is something that I personally prefer. A lot of people also prefer. As you can see, this Sanka also underneath the skin, a lot of more, yeah, gray is showing, indicators for more black popping up when this koi will grow. What is good on this koi, by the way, is that the head area, the red is all in between, like on the middle of the head, between the eyes. That's really good. And really, if you want to select a good Sanka, look for that nice red head pattern like this one has. So I'm not selecting this one as well, as I just mentioned. Okay. And maybe you think, okay, this guy is really critical. Well, maybe that's true, maybe not, I don't know. I'm just sharing my opinion with you, and hopefully you can also learn something out of that. So the third one. This one, the red pattern on the head, the previous one was really good. This one is a little bit less good, and the reason for that is, if you look at this eye, you can see that the red lays over the eye, and also the eye itself shows some orange red on it. That's not that good. Also, if you look at the nose, it looks like the red is a little bit fading away. Also an indicator for weaker red on this Sanka. Now, overall, this area is missing some red. So I'm not selecting this one as well. I think there are way better Sankas in this bowl that will come later, of course. So I'm also not selecting this one. Now, at the meantime, meanwhile, I'm also looking around a little bit, like which ones, in which order I'm going to show them to you. Well, let's start with this kind of Tansho looking like Sanka. So this is a Tansho Sanka. So why is this a Tansho? Maybe you know, because it only has a red marking on its head. And if a koi only has a red marking on its head, we call it a Tansho. But for example, if there would also be a pattern visible, more red dots visible, but at the same time around head pattern, then we would call it Maruten. So in combination with a red pattern, it's Maruten. If the entire koi is white, or with black markings like this one, of course, you call it Sanka. Now, what is nice on this one is that some black is showing in the dot. But honestly, if you look at the dot, it's not really a round dot. It's nice, it's a funny fish. It's nothing special. For that reason, I'm also not selecting this one. Continue with a little bit better Sanka, in my opinion. It's this one. Now, I say better because I think the red pattern is better. But overall, it's still not a really good koi. It has nice blue eyes. As you can see, this eye is red, not so preferred. In my opinion, this Sanka doesn't have enough white. And if you look at it, for example, from this side, you probably see also why I mean it. Almost the entire back of the koi is covered with red or black. Now, also the tail section, there's no white that just starts just before the tail, which we call the odome, which really gives the Sanka a better look. It makes the Sanka look bigger when the last section of the tail is white. Nice pattern. The red and the sumi is nice in balance, but not enough white. Also one of the eyes is red, so I'm not selecting this one as well. Okay, what I will do from now on is maybe skip some of the details that I already discussed, so we can go a little bit quicker throughout the rest of the koi. But of course, if you still have any questions about some of these koi that I selected, ask it. And I will try to comment on that, and of course share with you why I did certain picks or why I didn't. So I have here a Sanka with really intense sumi. So the black is really intense. Look at how dark this already is. Now I have to say, this Sanka is too dark. So it has too much sumi on this fish. So there's, yeah, the black areas are too large. But the intensity is really good. It's also shiny, as you can see probably. So it is a nice Sanke, too dark, and for that reason I'm not selecting it. The head pattern was also good, but too bad that it is that dark. But of course, there's one less that we didn't select. We actually didn't select even one koi yet, but oh well. Let's see if we end up with one that I can select. Another Sanke. And the head pattern is good, lace between the eyes, nice blue eyes, also good. The tail section is not wide, so it's not perfect. It shows tejime, and tejime is when you look at the fins. Maybe I have to use another example later for tejime, but let's try. If you look at this fin, you can see that it has one black stripe visible. And that black stripe is what we call tejime. I will just pick another one because this one is a little bit wild. The black is quite good. Placement is quite good. It is missing some black in this area. Maybe it will come later. What is missing on this koi to be really a nice koi is the last part of the tail should be white. And also the tree color area on the shoulder area. What I want, what I really prefer, and what is also appreciated by judges, is that both white, so shiroji, red, so the he, and sumi, so the black, is showing in this area. That all three colors are balanced and visible there. Probably we will have another example later. For that reason, I'm also not selecting this one. Continue with another Sanke. Zoom out a little bit, because this one is jumping around in the bowl. Heavy black on the head area, too intense in my opinion. The red lace nice between the eyes, nice blue eyes. Tail area doesn't show white, so some drawbacks for this Sanke, and also not selecting it for that reason. Then we have quite a different looking Sanke than the previous ones, but still quite nice. So only a little bit of red is visible on the head area for this one. And what I also see, it looks quite nice from a distance, but when you look from close by, you can see that this red seems to be fading away a little bit. So I'm a little bit scared that in the upcoming months, maybe even this red will disappear. And then this Sanke, well, is a total failure. Well, not a total failure, but it's not perfect any longer. Also, if you look to the lateral sides of the koi, as you probably know, if you watch more of my videos, a koi grows towards, so the lateral line will become more visible because it grows upwards. And I think if you look from the side, there's not really a lot of pattern visible on the side. So I think that it will look a little bit empty, too much white in that area. The intensity of red in this area and black is really good. It also has, probably the first one that we have, is the last part of the tail is white. So that's an odome, that's good. But still, yeah, because of this red area that probably will fade away, I will not select this Sanke. Same thing, red is a little bit weaker in this area. The black is really heavy on the back of the koi. Let me see. Yeah, too much black in this area. Red placements was quite nice. Also the tree color is okay, not super good, but okay. And one of the dorsal fins shows a lot of black, which I also don't really like on a Sanke. So for these reasons, I'm not selecting this one as well. So I'm just counting now. We have 10 Sanke already that we discussed. We didn't select any so far. But I think the quality is becoming a little bit better. I'm picking the worst ones out, I guess. This one. Black is really, again, super intense. Dark areas, lots of black visible also. I think, honestly, for that reason, it's not so balanced. If you look from close by, then you can see that all these areas, like almost in every white section, there is, so if you look at this, there's bluish, grayish tints visible that will all become black. So I'm almost 100% sure that this sunken will become too dark, and for that reason I also don't select it. Even though it has an O-dome, so white area in the tail, the head area, the red is quite well visible, shows, yeah, it is visible between the eyes. It would have been even better if the orange was a little bit longer, like laying just a little bit more towards the front of the head. Then it would be even better. Not selecting that one, as I mentioned. And now it is becoming more and more difficult, I think. Because of course I want to select the best ones out of this set. This sunk is the same things as most of the as the koi we selected. No O-dome visible. One eye is red and black, both red and black. I honestly think that this area is too dark, so I'm not selecting this sunk as well. And that koi that I just put away was really shiny, by the way. The skin quality was quite okay. Just not one of the best ones. This sunka, good red pattern on the head. Stops just before the eyes, that's good. This black placement is quite good. On the shoulder, that's good placement. Balance of the pattern, well, is quite nice in the end. There's no O-dome, so no white area. I think also when you look from the sides, that's quite okay-ish. So all the color is above the lateral line. The white is nice. So the shiroshi is nice, that's white. It is quite a good koi. Would have been better if some white was visible in this area. I'm a little bit doubting if I should select this one, but I'm not going to. And there is actually one reason for that. If you look at one of the dorsal fins here, you can see that there is a lot of orange visible in that fin. I don't think that will ever be disappearing, and I don't like that. No, I'm not selecting it. If you look at the orange in this area, you can see that the intensity is or orange or red, however you want to call it. Here the red is way more intense than here and here. So there's really differences in the intensity of the red pattern. And that's not something that you want on a sunka. You want that the intensity is the same over the entire fish. This sunka, also the black, is quite in balance, I would say. Quite good. Now the body posture of this fish is a little bit strange, and I know that it's probably more difficult to see, so I have to. What you can see is this area is quite okay. The body is okay here, the head is quite okay, but here in the middle, here it is quite thick, and then straight after it becomes really thin. So that's not a good proportion of the body. Maybe you can see it like this, I'm not sure. I hope you can see it. But the body posture of this koi is not good. And body is really important on any variety that you select. You want a good torpedo looking koi. If not, well, better leave it there. Or the pattern should be super, super good. But this sunken, well, the pattern is not super, super good, if I'm honest. Red is okay on the head. Black placement here is okay. It has some small black spots that are visible under the red here. Probably will come up later. It's not perfect. So I'm not selecting this sunken. But one thing I will use this sunken for, I mentioned it before. Tajime in the dorsal fins. Tajime is the black stripe that is visible. And I think you can see that now on this dorsal fin. Typical for Sanka, really is nice as well. It can make good balance visible on the koi. Because of the tajim, well, in my opinion, it makes a koi look more balanced. Also on Showa, for example, you have Motoguru. Motoguru are the large black dots in the dorsal fins. Also makes the Showa more balanced. Makes it more complete somehow. Okay. We have 7 left. And it is getting more difficult for me to get the best out of this selection. Okay. Next one is this one. This one has quite a playful pattern, I would say. The red nose, then the first step on the head, and some larger red step in the tail area from the middle of the body towards the tail. It has an O-dome, so the last part of the tail is white. The red lace in between the eyes. The black is quite well divided. What is still missing, but what is probably going to develop, is a black spot right on the shoulder area. And that shoulder area is important, as I mentioned. It's the first thing you see. It is the most important place, actually, on a Sanka to have black visible. And what I think will happen with this Sanka is that probably some black will appear here, and then you have the nice three color. You have white in that area visible, good visible, you have red visible in that area, and black. So I would say this Sanka is quite okay. Quite okay. Maybe on this side a little bit of red is missing. If you look at it, the tail area is all, there's no red. On the other end, that's way better. But I think let's keep it for now and let's discuss it later again. So let's keep the best koi, discuss these shortly again. And then I'm also going to ask you at that moment, like, which of the 3 or 5 that we have left is your favorite one? Or maybe I already put away your favorite one. That could also be. I would like to know that as well, of course. Let's share together. 6 left now. And I think I already know which ones I will select out of this one and which ones I won't. Okay, but let's just continue, of course. And I have to say, these 6 probably are already one of the better ones out of these 20 that we had, or 21 that we had. The balance of all of these 6 is way better. Also, this one, nice placement of Sumi. It doesn't have an O-dome, no white area. The red lace in between the eyes. White is quite good. I personally find the pattern in front, in this area, too heavy compared with the rest of the koi. This side is quite okay. Other side is, you probably see it, the thing I see is lot of red visible in the first part. Lot of red in this area, no red in that area. So for that reason also not selecting it. And by the way, what is really good on this koi is the tajima. On both fins, you can see 2 or 3 small stripes visible, lines visible of black. Good tajima placement. This Sanka was probably one of the larger ones that we had. Also on this Sanka, the tajim is very well placed. Very good tajim visible. Now, I won't select this Sanka. And the reason for that is not the skin quality, because the skin quality on this Sanka is good. It is, the red is intense, the black is intense, shows it has a lot of potential to pop up here. What is, well, a lot of aspects are good on this koi. No red below the lateral line, nice blue eyes, no red in the eyes, no red over the eyes. Black will pop up in this shoulder area. Now, a little bit more white could have been visible here. Maybe this gap, if it was a little bit higher, so that the white was more visible upwards, would have been a little bit better. But the reason why I'm not picking this one is it doesn't have an odome, so no white visible. And I think that this red patch is too large compared with the last part. And that breaks the balance for me a little bit. So for that reason, I'm not selecting it. Even though I think it is one of the better Sanka out of this selection regarding body posture and skin quality. This Sanka has one red eye, which I don't really like, but the red placement on the head is really good. Nicely between the eyes, also Tajima visible on the pectoral fins, which is quite nice. It has an odome, but really a small dot of orange is visible on the last part of the tail, but I think that will disappear. Not selecting this one because it is a little bit a boring pattern to me. It is only one big red step, so this is all red and then no more red. This gap of white is nice. That makes the tree color in the shoulder area. Nice skin quality. So it is quite a good Sanka. The pattern is not so special to me, and for that reason I'm not picking this one. So we have three more, and you know that I'm going to pick two out of these Sanka. And I will pick the one that I won't pick, and it's this one. And the reason is the heavy sumi placements that it already has. And under the skin, I can already see a bit more of black developing. It's all gray in that area, so I think there won't be a lot of white left. And for that reason, I won't pick it. And now maybe you are curious, like, what do we have left? That's this Sanka. Nice red markings on the head. Intensity of the red is really nice. It shines. The odome is not super. It does have some red in the tail area, but I think it is still okay because some white is around it. It's average, let's call it like that. I think the pattern is quite nice. The red is nicely divided, and that's why I keep this one. So blue eyes is good, there's no red laying on the eyes, so that's all good. And then the other one is this one. Same thing, no red over the eyes, the red on the head area is quite nice, sumi is still developing, will be more sumi, more black, as on the previous Sanka. The pattern, as you can see if you look from above, this red is quite nice divided. Well, it is not super, but it is quite nice divided. And for that reason, I'm also keeping this one. And now what I will do is, we have two keepers and one more that we put away 5 minutes ago or something. I will put that one back in this bowl, and we will discuss these three shortly. And I think we already passed like over the 20 minutes of video, but it is just difficult to explain a lot and then keep it short. But maybe you can also give me feedback on that. Like, do you like these longer videos, or do you prefer that I keep the videos a little bit shorter and maybe more to the point, so with less details? Let me know, and of course I will try to do my best to do it that way in the future. So we have three Sanka left, three totally different Sanka, and it's also fine, of course. What I like personally is more playful patterns. I also like more traditional patterns, so we have two more, well, I think one really traditional Sanka, one is a little bit in the middle with playful and also traditional, and one is more the playful kind of Sanka. Let's discuss them one by one. And I'm just going to ask you, I'm also going to give them a number, and please let me know which of these three is your favorite pick, and also tell me why. So let's start with number one. And number one is, I think, out of this mix, the most traditional Sanka. So this is number one. And I picked that one also for that reason, because it is more a traditional calm pattern, nicely divided, red, 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 nice O-dome, so white area in the tail. It has nice blue eyes, the red lace in between the eyes. The white is also really good, really shiny. The nose is, yeah, you can see the white is good there. Tail area is a good indicator for Shirogi that it is good quality. So this one has it. Overall, Morsumi will still develop. So you can see that some black is under the skin here that will come up. It's also nice to follow, of course. So this is number one. Then we have number two. That's the one that I mentioned a little bit more in between, like traditional combined with playfulness. Traditional part is the head area, nicely placed, red on the head. The blue eyes are good, the white is also good, skin quality is totally fine. The black still is going to develop a little bit more, because you can see some gray areas there. So that will come up still. It doesn't have an O-dome, but it also doesn't have no O-dome. So it's a little bit in between. You can see that some orange is on the last part of the tail, but it's only a little bit. I think it's a nice playful pattern. So this is number two. And we have the last one, which I call the most playful one. It's not really super traditional Sanka. Smaller sumi spots in this area. Well, the nose is playful, white on the middle of the head, but the red is not going over the eyes. Also, the eyes are still blue. Some black is going to develop in the shoulder area here. So this one is the number three. So number three, number two, number one. So let me know which one is your favorite pick. And for me, to come to that conclusion, the most playful one is for me the one that I would not select out of these three. Well, I like more playful patterns, but yeah, for a Go Sanka, so for a Sanka in this case, I also like that there's still some more of the traditional parts are visible. For that reason, this one would be on my last place. The most traditional, in my opinion, would be on the second place for me. So that's this one. And the one that I like the most, and I also would really like to see how this one is going to develop, is this one. That's really cool pattern that is going to develop. And I'm not going to repeat again why I would pick this one, because I already mentioned that, of course. So this is what I wanted to share with you about the selection of 2021 Sanka, which aspects I look for, and I hope that this video was really insightful for you. So if you enjoyed this video, you can also consider to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And I would really appreciate that, of course. And I hope that you will also like that, because then you will get notifications of all the new videos that I'm uploading. And we will at least do a video each week with covering different topics. So it can be that we select koi like this video. We have detailed guides where we explain more about a certain variety. For example, the Sorogoi variety that we uploaded 1 week ago. We do videos out of Japan, for example, mud pond harvesting, a lot more like baby koi selections, and I think everything that you want to know about koi. So subscribe to this YouTube channel and see you again in the next video. Thank you for watching.